Hi, this is Dr. A with your medical terminology video on the pathology of the nervous system. So we're going to start with brain pathology. Alzheimer's disease is a disorder that is characterized by dementia, progressive disorientation, apathy, and loss of memory. Anencephaly is a congenital defect in which parts of the brain do not develop. It is fatal soon after birth. Astrocytoma is a tumor that originates in the star-shaped neuroglial cells called astrocytes. And astrocytes are in part of the cells that help you make memories and make connections between your neurons. They have other roles too, but I thought that one was pretty cool. Brain tumor is either a benign or a malignant intracranial mass. It is dangerous because it causes pressure on the brain and then can cause loss of function in the area where there's pressure. Cerebellitis is an inflammation of the cerebellum. And this shows a CT, it shows a large malignant tumor in the left hemisphere of the brain, so you can see how it is interfering with everything that's functioning in that area of the brain. Cerebral aneurysm is a localized abnormal dilation of a blood vessel. A ruptured aneurysm is a common cause of a hemorrhagic cerebrovascular accident, also known as a hemorrhagic CVA or a hemorrhagic stroke. Cerebral contusion is the bruising of the brain from a blow or an impact. And cerebral palsy is brain damage that's resulting from a defect, trauma, infection, or an oxygen deprivation before, during, or shortly after birth. And this diagram shows aneurysms. So these are aneurysms, so these are bulging. These are not supposed to be there. They should look like this, right? And so you have a bulging of an artery, and then if that bulging ruptures and blood starts spewing out, then it can cause a cerebral hemorrhage. This is the circle of Willis, which is at the base of the brain. A cerebrovascular accident, or CVA, is an infarct due to the loss of blood supply to the brain. It is commonly called a stroke. The infarct can be a blockage, usually. So anything downstream from the blockage is not going to get blood supply. Chronic traumatic encephalopathy is characterized by blows to the head that result in progressive degeneration of brain tissue. So this is some chronic brain injuries. And a concussion is a mild traumatic brain injury from a blow or an impact. And so if you keep getting concussions over and over and over, especially in sports such as American football, even though they have their helmets and stuff, the blows to the head can cause chronic traumatic and encephalopathy, but also soccer players if they hit the ball with their head. Encephalitis is an inflammation of the brain. Epilepsy are seizures and loss of consciousness that is caused by an uncontrolled electrical activity of the brain. And so here are some examples of causes for CVAs, or cerebrovascular accidents, also known as strokes. So we have cerebral hemorrhage here, where an artery ruptures and bleeds into the brain tissue. Now, of course, the problem with this is that the brain is contained in the skull, and the skull does not have the capacity to expand. And so if there's blood that accumulates, it's going to press down on the brain tissue. Whereas in other places, you would see, the blood would push the soft tissue out, and you'd see a mounting amount of blood or bruise, etc., that would present itself. Cerebral embolism is an embolus. It's a clot, so it comes from another area, let's say maybe the leg, and it lodges in a cerebral artery and blocks blood flow, and then anything downstream from the blockage will lack blood flow and that tissue will start to die. Cerebral thrombosis is the blood clot forms in the cerebral artery and blocks the blood flow. So the damage is actually in the cerebral artery and the blood clot forms there, but the consequence is the same as a cerebral embolism. And then a compression is the pressure from a tumor that squeezes the blood vessel and blocks the blood flow. And of course, then the consequence is still that the tissue downstream from the blockage is going to die. Hydrocephalus, the accumulation of cerebrospinal fluid within the brain ventricles. It is treated with the creation of an artificial shunt that drains the brain fluid, the cerebrospinal fluid, usually into like the chest or abdominal cavity there, not to the outside. Migraine is a specific type of headache with severe pain, light sensitivity, dizziness, and nausea. Parkinson's disease is a chronic disorder of the brain with fine tremors, muscle weakness, rigidity, and a shuffling gait. It tends to occur in men more often, whereas Alzheimer's disease tends to occur in women more often, although either can get either one. So here's an example of hydrocephalus. And so you would see a bulging fontanelle, enlarged ventricles, which, you know, are where the spinal fluid is being created and flows. You can have a block aqueduct here that would allow the spinal fluid to flow down to the spine. And then here is the shunt that they put in, and it allows excess spinal fluid then to go like down, I believe, into the thoracic cavity. Brain pathologies continued. We have Reye's syndrome is a combination of acute encephalopathy and organ damage. It follows a viral infection, but it's also associated with treating the fever with aspirin, which is now why we don't recommend giving aspirin to children. Shaken baby syndrome is caused by violent shaking. Symptoms will include subdural hematoma, brain swelling, and retinal bleeding. A transient ischemic attack, or TIA, is a temporary interference with the blood supply to the brain. It may lead to a CVA or a stroke. Sometimes these can be called mini strokes. Traumatic brain injury, or TBI, is damage to the brain resulting from impact, blast waves, or a penetrating projectile. So now moving on to the spinal cord pathology. ALS, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease, is a condition of degeneration of the motor neurons of the spinal cord. It is an autoimmune disease. Meningocele is a protrusion of the meninges through an opening in the vertebral column. Myelitis is an inflammation of the spinal cord, and myelomeningocele is a protrusion of the meninges and the spinal cord through an opening in the vertebral column. Poliomyelitis is a viral infection of the gray matter of the spinal cord. Paralysis may be mild and temporary or severe and permanent. Spina bifida is a congenital defect where the laminae of vertebrae do not meet or close to form a spinal canal. And a spinal cord injury is damage to the spinal cord due to trauma. The cord may be bruised, temporary, or severed, which then would cause permanent damage. And then here's an example of a meningocele. So we have a meningeal sac here with cerebral spinal fluid, but the spinal cord is still contained in the spinal column. We have a myelomeningocele where the spinal cord also protrudes through that meningocele with the spinal fluid, etc. And then we have spina bifida where, you know, the nerve fibers are here through the spinal cord. There's usually a tuft of hair there, a dimpling of the skin, and then this parts of the vertebrae here are missing. Bell's palsy, so this is a nerve pathology. So Bell's palsy is a one-sided facial paralysis that is due to facial nerve inflammation. The inflammation is typically viral in nature, and most patients recover. Guillain-Barré syndrome is a loss of myelin sheath from the nerves. It might be autoimmune, and it begins in the leg and progresses up towards the trunk. It could also be tied to viral diseases, viral infections, and sometimes also a side effect of vaccination. Multiple sclerosis, MS, is an inflammatory disease of the central nervous system. It's also an autoimmune disease. It causes weakness and numbness due to loss of the myelin sheath from the nerves, and plaques can appear. And this one is a little harder to diagnose. Both of them, Guillain-Barré and multiple sclerosis, takes extensive testing to figure out what's going on. Myasthenia gravis, another autoimmune disease where you will have muscular weakness and fatigue due to an insufficient amount of neurotransmitter at the synapse, and this is because there is an autoantibody that latches on the receptors. And so you can't, you know, the signals can't pass through. A neuroma is a tumor of a nerve or the sheath around a nerve. Neuropathy is a general term for a disease of or a damage to a nerve. Polyneuritis is an inflammation of two or more nerves, and radiculitis is an inflammation of a nerve root. Radiculopathy is a condition caused by a herniated disc that puts pressure on a nerve root. A herniated disc kind of slips, right? And so that causes pain. Shingles is an eruption of painful blisters on the body along a nerve path. It is caused by herpes zoster virus, which is, shingles is the same virus that causes chickenpox. Trigeminal neuralgia is a sudden sharp pain in an area of the face that is served by the trigeminal cranial nerve. It is usually caused by pressure on or irritation of the nerve. A little bit on meninges pathology. We have epidural hematoma is a mass of blood in the space outside of the dura mater of the brain and the spinal cord. A meningioma is a tumor of the meninges. Meningitis is an inflammation of the meninges that can be due to a viral or a bacterial infection. A subdural hematoma is a mass of blood forming beneath the dura mater due to a tear in the meninges. It can exert fatal pressure on the brain. And then here is an example of a subdural hematoma. You have a torn cerebral vein that's bleeding here. You have some dural hematoma and it compresses the brain tissue. We have the arachnoid layer here, but the dura mater layer right here. So that's why it's subdural. All right, so that wraps up our brain pathologies for you.